My name is Shane Sparks. I'm from Titusville, Florida, and my major is finance. Over the summer at Siemens, I was working in Orlando in the commercial sales group for the large gas turbines for the Americas, which involves North America, South America, and Canada. And essentially what I did there was cost curve analytics involving the payment schedules of new bids that customers would put out to us. Generally, the contracts I dealt with were between $50 to $250 million, so the payment schedules played a pretty integral part in actually calculating how much a customer has to put down or pay throughout the 36-month process of acquiring the products that they're looking at, which in this case are gas turbines. A lot of the classroom, or a lot of the things you learn in the finance here at Stetson do involve investments, but at the same time, they also teach you to balance it with corporate finance, because a lot of people are kind of fooled by the misconception that finance is only investments, and that's what you have to do with a degree in finance. It's not that at all. So I felt like the well-rounded knowledge of finance, including cost curve analytics, managing that with economics and things like that, really helped me kind of understand the holistic picture when I was doing the cost curve analytics. Rather than the stock market, you still analyze, but this is on the other side, corporate, and we even have corporate finance classes for this specific reason. A lot of the professional skills just came through development and actually learning what a job was. I mean, you can sit back all day and dream about your first job or where you're going to work and whatnot, but actually, once you actually even intern somewhere, you realize, no, it's not like TV. You know, it's 9 to 5, 8 to 5, if not more, every day. You don't get to go on 3-hour coffee breaks. You don't get to just do nothing. So it really taught me a lot about time management. You get a lot on your plate, so it's at times hard to balance that. You know, you feel like you have to do everything in one day, and that's just not possible. So you really learn how to kind of manage your priorities, communicating in a company. I mean, Siemens employs over 500,000 people worldwide in over 190 countries. So it is definitely something I learned, is how to communicate with people that I've never even met before, asking them for certain information. For example, with my cost curve project, I had to ask several people from different departments, even in Germany and other countries, for specific information, and I've never met them before. So that's really a skill that I think that's undervalued, that people don't really understand how difficult it is. I would say this affected me personally, by the biggest part being I originally thought I wanted to go into investments. When I interned for Siemens, I flat out told the interviewers that I wasn't sure what I wanted to do, and that's why I really was looking at Siemens, because they offer that corporate financial aspect rather than just investment banking. And I would say that's the biggest personal thing I learned, is throughout my internship, I discovered that I had a passion for corporate finance rather than the stock market. As far as professional goals go, I started to realize probably about midway through the internship that I didn't really want to go into investment banking, and that I actually really like Siemens. I like the size of the company. It's one of the largest in the world. It has a huge global impact, which is it's interesting to me, and it's very stable. You know, it's something that I don't have to worry about waking up and not having a job. And actually, at the end of my internship, I was actually offered a job offer to participate in their finance leadership development program. So coming July 8th, 2015, I actually have a full-time job, and I'm only a week into my senior year.